6 peculiarities of the English language that are mind-boggling for English. From the days of Chaucer and Shakespeare to the present, the English language has been filled with some amazingly peculiar and bizarre examples of speech and grammar. As the English sailed around the globe, colonizing it to the extent the sun never set on the British Empire, the number of words that were adopted by the language could not help but grow. Along with this vocabulary growth, so too did the number of expressions and grammatical rules that seemed to make no sense when actually examined. One could say that English has been beating up other languages in dark alleys, then going through their pockets for loose grammar and spare vocabulary for centuries. This post was written by our ITTT graduate John C. Chop down or chop up. English can be a confusing method of communication even for native speakers. One chops down a tree, but then chops up firewood. Trying to explain the different uses of up and down to a non-native speaker of English can be one of the more daunting exercises one can subject themselves to. Oh, words. Then imagine why a new learner might be confused when being confronted with words that have O in them. The fact that O can be pronounced many different ways: cough, rough, bow, through, thorough, thought, dot, while other words are spelled differently but pronounced the same way, such as sell and sell, wheel and wheel, new and new. Then there is the classic there and there, read or read. Further confusion arises from words that are spelled the same but are pronounced differently. Root being pronounced either root or route, read being pronounced read or read. Other words that also fall into this special class of confusion are either content, tear, dough, invalid, desert, and so on. Silent letters. Then we find ourselves in a special little minefield, the world of words that have a silent letter in them. Some examples from this world of pain are net, knife, aisle, debt, soften, and dumb. New words. Our next stop on this train ride into the absurd are words that contain U but sound different. Blood and flood sound like cut or mud. Good, hood, stood, wood, shook, brook, crook, look all sound alike. Food, boot, mood, scoot, roof and hoof all have a long U sound. Floor and door have long O sounds. Buffalo what? We are now possibly at the deepest pit of grammatical hell with the following sentence. Buffalo, 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 buffalo. This sentence is grammatically correct because buffalo is a noun, a hoofed animal, that is sometimes incorrectly called a bison. It is a city in New York State, and it is also a verb that means to intimidate or overawe someone. So to paraphrase the sentence so that it does not hurt your brain, here goes. Bison from Buffalo, New York, that are intimidated by other bison in the community also intimidate other bison in Buffalo. What are your favorite English peculiarities? How these peculiarities came about are as organic and ever-evolving as the English language continues to adapt to our ever-changing world. Native speakers take these types of expressions in stride generally, not even thinking about the actual word structure being used. These peculiarities can be maddening for someone trying to learn English, however. Are you ready to teach English abroad? Apply now for your TEFL TESOL certification course and start teaching in a matter of months. Speak with an ITTT advisor today to put together your personal plan for teaching English abroad. Send us an email or call us toll-free at 1-800-490-0531 to speak with an ITTT advisor today.